Hello everyone, it's John here from Winning Solutions Inc. and today I will be bringing you all another Microsoft Access Expert template walkthrough. I will be showing you where to find the template database on a website, how to download the template database demo, and how to use the demo properly. Most of our templates are not designed to be used on their own. Instead, they are designed in a way that makes it simple and smooth to integrate into an existing database that you're already using. You can also build a more robust Microsoft Access database that is built around one of our templates. If you would like to create a new database that is based off one of our templates and don't know how, or don't have the time to do so, let us know and we'd be happy to help you getting the database that 100% fits your needs. With most of our templates that we offer, there are three different versions that you can purchase: a compiled runtime version, one for internal use, and one for unlimited developer use. The compiled runtime version is a run-as-is version without the paid full version of Microsoft Access using free access runtime from Microsoft. It can be integrated into your existing Access application, but you will not be able to make any modifications to the forms, reports, modules, etc. This option is more for those of you who don't see any need to make any customizations to the template. The internal use is a version that allows you to use or modify the databases however you wish within the organization. The unlimited developer use allows you to use the database template however you wish for any applications you develop. And it also allows you to distribute the template as part of a database you create. Winning Solutions Inc.'s templates have a strong advantage over shrink wrap software that you purchase from a store or website. With our templates, you receive the source code along with your purchase, so you are able to customize and update the database as you please. With shrink wrap software, you do not receive the source code when purchasing the software, and that means you can't update or customize the database. In our video today, we will be working with a demo version of our database template. A demo is a simple way that you can view or try out our database templates so that you can determine if you would like to purchase the database template or not. This is great for customers due to the fact that all of our sales are final. And our sales are final because we give you the source code when you purchase a template, and once we give you that source code, there's really no way you can return it. If you would like to test our demos for multiple days, you're free to do so. You just have to leave the database open so the data you entered will not be wiped. Our demos are designed so that once you close the demo, all the data entered is wiped from the database. And you have to purchase the full version if you would like to save your data that you enter. Upon downloading a demo, you have to unzip the downloaded file. And zipped files make it much easier to send and download large files over the web, so that's why we do that. Unzipping a file is very simple, though. All you have to do is extract the file so you have access to the uncompressed file. If you do not know how to do it or don't understand how to unzip a file, check out our YouTube channel and watch the How to Unzip One of Our Files video tutorial to learn the simple step. The link to that video is in the description of this video, actually. So now let us get into downloading and testing one of our own demos. All right, we're going to start off by going to our website, microsoftaccessexpert.com. On the top of the website, there is a toolbar right up here, and this is all the various ways to contact Winning Solutions Inc. And if you go over to the sidebar on the left and go under Database Templates for Sale, and then click on Database Templates List. All right, this is a view of all of our templates that we offer. And as you can see, it's broken up into categories. First one is Most Popular, second is Appointment and Scheduling, Calendars, and so on, all the way down to Database Tools and Miscellaneous Templates. All right, today I will be showing you the Access Realtor Appointment Tracking Database Template. So double click on this one, and what you will need to do is download the demonstration that correctly corresponds to the version of Access your computer has. Once the file is downloaded, go ahead and open it, and that's where this would be. Next, you will need to extract that file since it is in a zipped folder. Okay, and now you will be able to open the database without any issues. Alright, this is just a security notice. This is just something that is downloaded from the web and your computer thinks that it could be harmful. This software is safe, so you can go ahead and open it. Okay, so this database is great for keeping track of appointments and all of your customers in one spot. To start, we'll do add new customer. Okay, here's where you can add in their name. Smith. Okay, and this is just a suffix spot, so first, second, third, junior, senior. I'll do junior. You don't have to add in one of those if you don't want to. Okay, job title, we'll do consultant. And picture, you can add a picture if you want to. You just click on the big blank space and click on manage attachments. And here's where you can add new ones from your computer. You just have to find where they are. I don't have any pictures on here, but that's what you can do. And just click open. And then they would show up on here. And that's what you can use. I'll add in an email, test@test.com. You can add in a web page address if you want to, IM address. Put in a phone number. Okay, and you can also do an address if you want to. You can do notes, call history, appointment history, payment history, all that sort of stuff. So it's pretty detailed. You can either print this information for the customer, or you can save and add a new one, or you can just save and close, and that's what I'll do. Let's just save and close. Okay, once that customer is in the system, you can search for them by going into Search Customers. Okay, here you can search by any criteria. You can do name, job title, any of those that were on the customer form. I'll just search by last name and search, and there's John Smith. And from here you can double click on it if you want to re-edit that information, or if you need to delete that file or print it. You can also do an export to Excel, and that would show up. It would start up Excel for you and just export all that information to it. Okay. All right. The next thing you can do is add an appointment. To do that, go to calendar view, and here's where you can pick any slot you want on any day. I'll just stick with April 26th, 2016. You can also change the format of the calendar if you want to. So there's all your week, bi-weekly, monthly, and any of them that you want. And you can also show it just for one realtor. If you just want all of your appointments that are going on, you can just do realtor one. And here's where you can add an appointment just by double clicking on a slot. So I'll do one for 8 o'clock to 8:30. Customer, we'll do that one that we just created, John Smith, for realtor one type. All of these can be changed if you need to change them. I'll just do group for right now though. And location one. Okay, you can add notes to it if you want. Add in more workers if you need to, and add payment information. Okay, lastly, before we save and close this, you can select a custom color for it. This will help with the organization part of the calendar. Okay, save and close, and as you can see, that color shows up on the calendar now. So what you can do is double click if you need to edit the appointment or delete it. I'll just leave it there for right now. Now you can add another appointment anywhere you want, or you can print the calendar for that day right up here. You can also change views, expanded view. Yeah, this would just show all of the appointments for each realtor. So that's pretty nice, organizational-wise. Okay, next we'll take a look at the maintenance. Let's see, go back to the main menu. So maintenance lookups. So these are all the preset information that you'll find everywhere, all those drop boxes. This is where you can change that information. We can go into realtors, change all the realtor names. Just do Jeff. Okay, and you can also add additional ones if you want to. Jane. Sure. Okay. All right, address types. All of this stuff you can change if you need to. So you don't need to save it, you can just click close down here. Okay, the calendar setup form. Let's see. This allows you to change some calendar options and color if you want to do something like that. One interesting thing that you can activate in here is the activate user login, which is right down here. Okay, if I activate that and save and close, go back into maintenance lookups, and then at the bottom here, user logins. Here's where all you can set the security stuff for the database. Who's admin, who's not. You can change all their usernames, passwords, stuff like that. So when you open the database, you would need to enter your username and password, and based on that, it would give you certain features. Okay. And keep in mind, if you do close this database, all the information will be deleted since it is a demonstration. Okay. When you purchase the full version, it will always save the information regardless if you close it or not. Okay, another thing you can do is search for those appointments that you created. You can just hit run search if you want to just search them all. I only have one in here, so that's why only one pops up. With that one, let's see, if you have view and calendar form clicked or selected, if you double click your appointment, it will show up on the calendar. Go back to search, and if you select view an appointment form and you double click it, it will show back up in the appointment, and you can edit it, all sorts of stuff, delete it, whatever. Okay, and there's a number of different options you can do with all these search results. You can export them to Excel, Outlook Calendar, Outlook Task, and you can do a print detail. Okay, and that's what would show up on that printed preview. And then a print summary, less information, fit more stuff on that page if you need to do that. Okay, and you can search by all these different criterias too. Yep. And then clear it if you want to restart the search. That's all there is to that one. Okay, back to the main menu. One more thing, look at the reports. You can print invoices, accounts receivable, cash ledgers. Okay, and you can do these by dates. Okay, so we'll do Friday the 8th. I think that was Friday. Yeah, Friday the 8th to Friday the 22nd. You can do all the invoices for that certain time period. And that's what that would look like. If you had information on that or during those dates, they would show up in there. Okay, that's all there is to this database. I'm going to go ahead and thank you guys for taking your time to watch this Microsoft Access Expert Template walkthrough brought to you by Winning Solutions, Inc. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please feel free to give us a like or subscribe to our YouTube channel for tons of other walkthroughs and tutorials. As always, feel free to contact us for any of your IT needs, whether it be programming needed, you want to buy a template, or you need help customizing a template. contact us whenever you would like. I'm going to go ahead and post our contact information in the description below of this video. Also, you can find us on about any social media website. Feel free to follow us or like us on any of those. And have a great day. Thank you.